The next topic is delivery and forwarding of any packets. In this, we will discuss how to forward the packets from the source to destination, how these packets are forwarded from router to router to reach to the destination. So we'll see here
how the routing table is maintained.
So delivery means we are interested to find out how the packet is delivered from one machine to another machine. So there are two kinds of delivery. One is called direct delivery and indirect. We'll discuss two kinds of delivery today. The first is called direct delivery. A delivery is said to be direct when the source and destination belong to the same network. If your source and destination is a part of same network, it is said to be a direct delivery. There is also a case of direct delivery. Even if this is your network, this is source, this is destination, both are in the same network, this is a direct delivery. Or if there are two networks, this is one network, this is another network, and if this machine want to send something to this machine and it has to go through some routers, we have two different networks. This is one network, we can assume. This is another network, we will assume. One, this is a host machine in the one network, there is a host machine in the network, and this machine wants to communicate to this machine and it has to go through some router. This is one router, second router, okay. Then the router which is connected to the destination router, this is also a direct delivery. So direct delivery has two conditions. One is either the source and the destination will be in the same network, or the last router, which is, it is done with the help of the destination address. So here the destination address is used to do the delivery. So this is a scenario. We have two machines, A and B, both are the part of the same network. This is one case of direct delivery, or any router which is connected to this network is also a case of direct delivery. Indirect delivery, where the source and the destination are a part of different network, then this is indirect. But every indirect delivery also takes one direct delivery. So whenever, if you look at this figure, this is A machine and B machine, both belong to different networks. So as a concept, this is an indirect delivery. But when it goes from this router to this router, then to this router, now from this router to the destination, this is a direct delivery. Because we discussed that the last router, direct delivery. So in every indirect delivery, there is one direct delivery. Then forwarding. Forwarding means how the routers forward the packet to the next router so that the packets can reach to the destination. So here we will see that the communication is happening in two ways. One is with the help of connectionless and one is called connection oriented. Connectionless, we discussed already, is a datagram service where there is no need to establish a path and the packets are moving independently to reach the destination. In the connection oriented, this is called virtual circuit. In the virtual circuit, there are three phases. The first phase is called the setup phase, where you have to establish a path. And once you establish a path, then you can do the data transfer. And the last phase is called tear down phase. Okay. So in the connection less service, we are doing this kind of communication with the help of destination address. If you remember, we discussed already. But in the connection oriented, we are doing this with the help of label. So here we use label, and in this we use destination address. Now how the forwarding is done? So forwarding is a job of the router. When the packet goes to router, the router has to decide where to forward the packet. What does that mean? It means, let's say there is one, this is maybe a router which is connected to different, this is one network connected to this, one network connected to this. So these are the different networks which connect to router. So whenever any packet goes to the router has to decide that the packet to be forwarded to this part or here or here. Okay, now this decision is made based on the information that is with the router. We call it routing table. So how this routing table is actually made? So we have different strategies, logic for this. So these are the different called next hope method. So far we feel that a router is something which have the information of the entire internet. So if the router is a part of internet, then if any packet goes to router, the router has every information that what are the different networks connected in the internet, and it can easily forward the packet. So with this information, if you look here, so this four method we discuss in context of connectionless, that is with the help of destination address. And there is another approach that is for connection oriented. Here we'll take the consideration of label. We'll look at a scenario. This is a network where machine A wants to communicate to machine B, which is a part of another network. So what we are assuming that we have the full information, means the element, the component which is a part of internet must have full information that how the packets to be routed. So A wants to send to B, so A must have information that it first go to router 1, then router 2, and then go to host B. Similarly, the router 1 maintains the information that to deliver anything to host B, it has to deliver to R2 and then to host B. Similarly, R2 maintains the information, if something to deliver to host B, it has to go to host B. So this is the information which the tables is actually maintaining. Because this is a very small scenario, so we can see that, and here host B maintains so much information, R1, R2, host B, right? What is it? But it is realized that it is actually not required to keep a note of the entire path. You simply keep a note of the next hop only. What does it mean? It means it is required that for A machine, if something to be delivered to host B, only the interest is where to deliver next, means to deliver to R1. And R1 will take a note that to deliver anything to host B, just forward to R2. So only next hop is actually important. If something coming to the router, router must take a note that what is the next hop that will take care of this packet. So only one entry is required in the routing table, and this is called next hop, where we only take a note of the next hop. Then the next is network specific method. This is a better proposal than the previous one. Now if you look at a scenario, this is a network N2, a packet to either A or B or C or D, but it must have the information in its routing table that if I want to send to A, I must forward to R1, or if I want to send to B, I must forward to R1, or to C, R1, and D, R1. Similarly, if the network is having 100 machines, it will take 100 entries. Is it okay? Now this will mean that, you know, if you go with this approach, you need many entries. So what is the better proposal? It says don't make a note of the host machine, but make a note of the network. So there is only one entry is there now. If you want to go to N2, then you have to go to R1. That means if somebody wants to go to A machine, then it is a part of N2, then it is already here. If somebody wants to deliver to host D, then D is a part of N2, it's already here. So there is no need to make a separate entry, only you make one entry for the network. Then host specific is a kind of combination of next hop and the network address. So in the next hop, what we are doing, in the next hop we are only making an entry of the next router, next hop. And then the network specific, we are making an entry of the network only, fine. So if you look at this, let's say I will change here some entry. Let's say I will make this R1 to make it better understand this. Now, this is your network 3. And let's say network 3, we have some more host machines are there, A, C, D, and E. Okay. Now, there is a table which is maintained. Now, if something is to deliver to A, then A is a part of network 3, so it will look to the network 3 and deliver through R1, means through this path will go. If something will deliver to C, then it is a part of N3 and it is delivered through R1. Is it okay? You understand this? So similarly, for any of the host machine which is a part of network 3, it will go through this path. But if something to deliver to host B, means B machine, then it will deliver through this path. So So there may be some requirement, sometimes it is required to give a specific path. Now, what are the cases? The cases may be, maybe host machine is a very special machine where you want to deliver a very secure packet. So already it is known that this path R1, if any of the other hosts like A, C, D, E, we will follow this path, but only for B, we will follow this path. So we make a special entry that host B will be through R3. So the one of the reason is, if you want to deliver a, if you want to provide a secure path, then you can use this kind of method. Or if you want to check the availability of the path or network path, if you want to find out through the R3, then also you can make one entry here. In the default method, what is happening in this method? There is no need to write all the entries in the routing table. You can write some of the entries, and the other entries you can write as the default. So default entry means if the match is not found. What does that mean? It means this is a routing table. Okay, and let's say this is a routing table for any router, and this is the structure of router, let's say, and it connects to one network here, it connects to one network here, and also it connects to some other routers here. Now this is network 2, this is network 1, and this is interface M0, this is interface M1, and this is interface M2. Now if any packet comes to the router which wants to go to network 2, so router will check, okay, N2 I have the entry, I will forward through M1, means through this path I have to deliver. If any packet want to go to N1, then router has the entry, I will forward through this. If let's say some packet comes which wants to go to network 5, now there is no entry of network 5 here, so router has one entry that is called default entry, which is 0.0.0.0, you remember? And here it is set M2, means if nothing is found in the table, then it will send to a default that I don't have the information, but I am sending you to other router, he will handle this. So this is called default method. Now how the router will finalize how to forward the packet, it has to do some steps. So we'll take one by one all the scenarios. So the first scenario is, classful address without subnetting. So we'll discuss classful address without subnetting, classful address with subnetting, and classless addressing. That means if we go with all the three different options, then how the router is going to handle this. So the first step is, whenever any packet goes to the router will take the destination address from that packet and find the class. How to find the class? When the destination address goes to the router, let's say this is the destination address, it will apply the shift operation 28 bits. Of this 4 bits, router has to identify which class it is. So let's say 4 bits are like this. This is first bit is 0 and remaining bits are 3 bits. So now it has many combinations, like maybe all are 0 or 0, 0, 1 or 0, 1, 0 and so on, 1, 1, 1. And this is value 1 to 7, is it? So that means if you have 0 to 7 value, this is class A. Means this address is a class A address. Otherwise, if you have this scenario, out of 4 bits, first and second is 10. Now you can make it 00 or 01 or 10. So this is 8, 9, 10. And also you can make 11. 11. So if it is 8 to 11, then it is class B. Is it okay? Similarly, if it is 110, you can have two options. You can make it and other is 1110 or 1111. So this is 14 is class D and 15 is class E. So by applying the shift operation, one can identify that the address belongs to which class. This is okay. Then after this, you need to apply the masking. Now masking is apply to find out the network, right? So this part is done. First you find the destination address, take the copy of it, apply the SIFT operation, find the class, do the masking, find the network address. This part is done. Fine. Then the router maintains three classes. If you are doing classful addressing, then router is actually maintaining class A, class B, class C. Okay. If the address is for the class A, okay. If the address is for the class A, it will search in the class A. Means the destination address is a class A address. Then the router is having three tables: class A table, class B table, class C table. And if the address is for class A, it will only search class A table. If the address is for class B, it will search only class B table. And accordingly, it will decide. If the match is found, then it will look to the corresponding entry of the interface and forward the packet. If the match is not found, it will go to default value and then forward to the default interface. This is how the things work. But there is one more step included. Once the match is found, if the address which is required, means the destination address which is written in the packet, if it is available in the table of the routing table, it is available, then it will take the next hop address and the interface number and send to A. I will make one example here. So it makes three columns. One is the network address. This is your network address. This is your called next hop. And the other is called interface. So we have three columns are there in the routing table: network address, next hop. Next hop means the router which is connected to this, and the interface. So let's say a packet which is to be delivered wants to go to network 2, and network 2 entry is found here, and this network 2 is directly connected to this router. So if it is directly connected, then there is no entry. Okay, what does it mean? It means this is a router and this is network 2 and it is connected directly, and the packet, this is one packet that is to be delivered to network 2. So the router will see that this packet to deliver to network 2, which is directly connected here. So it will look into the table, it will find, it will also see that which interface, let's say this interface is M0. So through M0 this packet has to be forwarded. Okay, so if the match is found here, the match is found, it will look two values. One is the hope, if there is any address, this address, and the interface, this value is passed to the ARP. ARP is one module, one protocol is there, which help us to find the MAC address. If you remember, we discussed already, we provide the IP address and the MAC address of the source machine, we get the MAC address of the destination machine, right? Here what we are doing, once the address is found in the table, we take the IP address, the interface value, and pass to the ARP, and ARP will return the MAC address of the next hop. Okay, now how all these things will work, we will discuss ARP algorithm in detail. There we will see that how the things are working. But here we are passing two values, IP address and the interface value, and we get in return as a MAC address of the next hop. Now this is the module, how the things work. This is, you can see the logic. Packet will receive by the router. Router will take the destination address and we will apply the SIFT operation. By SIFT operation, to find the class. If the class D is D or E, it is rejected because D or E is not assigned to any of the machines. If it is A, B and C, it will apply the mask and find the network address. This part is okay. Then this address is searched in any of the three tables. If the address is class A, search here. If it is class B, search here. If it is class C, search here. If it is find, if the entry is find, then take these two values, give to ARP, and ARP will give the how the things will work. So here is the scenario. Show the routing table for R1. So we need to draw the routing table. Now see here, routing table contains three parts. This is network address, next hop address, and the interface number. So now we will draw the routing table for R1. This is your R1, and we need to make a routing table for this. So here you can see, I'll make one routing table here for R1. So here we have three columns: first column, second column, and this third column. Okay, Already we have seen that we are discussing the classful addressing, so we have to make three routing tables. One is for class A, class B and class C. So let's say this is for class B. Similarly, we have to make table for class A. Do you understand what I am doing? This is for class A. Similarly, I have to make one table for class C. This is, we have three entries and this is class C. Now, this is the router which I am, means I am drawing a table for this router. Now this router connects to this network. You understand this? Now what is the network address? 145.80. 145 is what? Class B. So the entry goes here. 145.80.0.0. And it connects directly, so there is no entry here. And it connects to port M1. Now we look to this network. 170. 170 is again class B. So we'll make the entry in the class B table. 170.14.0.0. It is also connected 111.0.0.0, and it is connected directly and it is through M0. Now we'll look at this network. Now this network, what is the 192? 192 is class C. Okay, so we'll write the entry here. 192.116.7.0. But this is not directly connected. So we have to write the address through which it connects to this address, right? So you have to write this here. I'm writing here 111.15.17.32 and it comes through M0. So M0 means if any packet to be delivered to this network, it has to be delivered through this port only. You understand this? Right? And this is the next hop address which connects to this network. So, and then what is left? Now this is called default. So there is one entry that is called default entry. So it will write the default entry that is 0.0.entry. So it is connected to this IP. So we'll write 111.30.31. Is writing okay? Okay. And it is to M0. Now this is the structure of R1. Sir? What we just made here, A, B, C, and D, and this is the answer here. Is this okay? So here we have like blank here, but here we have this address in the class C. This is one numerical, and we need to find out how the router will decide if this packet goes to the router. This is the same topology which we have just studied. Now this packet with this address comes to the router. And router has to decide what to do. So what the router will do? First, router will take the address, apply the do the shift operation. Shift operation, it will find the class. What is this class? This is class C. So we find that this is class C. Apply the mask. What is the mask? 255.255.255.0 and then .7.0. Is it? So this is your network address you find. Now you have to search this network address in the table C. Okay, so you go to table C and you see this is available or not. Now you find that this is matching here. And you will take this value and give to AR. Actually, this packet has to forward to M0 port. This you have find out that router will forward this packet through M0 interface. But before that, it will send this information to the ARP and will get the MAC address of the next hop. Okay, so the answer is the router will forward the packet through M0 interface. This is the answer. If this address is not found here, then what is the answer? We will say the address is not found in the table and it will send to default route and through M0 interface. This is the answer. If it is not found. So the packet reaches to the router. Router takes this packet and will take the destination address. With this destination address, it will apply the shift operation of 28 bits, find the class, and with the class, what is the class? Class is B, so mask is 255, and then you can find the network address. So this is 167.24.0.0, and then you will search this entry in class B. Okay. So we'll go back and search this in class B 167, this is 124. So it is not existing in class B, right? Is your class B? It's not exist here. Then we go to default, and the answer is the entry is not existing in the table, and router will send to the default interface. This is M0. Then with subnetting, the next is with subnetting. So far we are discussing the without subnetting. So the concept remains the same. Whatever we discussed so far will remain the same. We will take the destination address and then apply the sifting. But here the things, the only difference is earlier we are applying the masking of the default mask. To find the network address, we apply the default mask. But now we will apply the subnet mask. This is the only difference. So we'll look at this module. So again, the same thing. We will take the address. We will do the sift operation, find the class, apply the mask, but it's a subnet mask, and then check the address in the table which is available to us. We'll take one example. Now this is a scenario. Now this is a network. This is a network. This is one network given to us, and this is one network, and it is 16. 16 means what? This is actually 16 bits are used for network. Now if you look at the subnet, subnet is having 18. So that means we have used 2 bits from the host ID. From the host we have taken 2 bits. That means 2 power 2 is equal to 4 subnets are possible. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 subnets are and all are of equal size as per the property. Now we have to make a routing table. So here you can see that this is the subnet 1, this is whose address is this 145, this, and it connects with M0 interface. Similarly, this is a subnet 2 and it connects through M1. So we will make one entry like this. This is your subnet address through M0, through M1, this is through M1, this is through M2, this is through M3. And the rest, this is x.y.z.t means we are not aware about the address. So this is simply we have written, means whatever address is there, we are simply forwarding to the default route. If it is not a part of subnet, then and these are the entry. So the same process we will apply again. If any numerical is given to you, we will apply the same process and we'll check what the router will do. Then we are moving to classless. Now in the classless, we don't have information about the classes. So here in the classless, what we will do, we will make, so far we have seen that the routing table makes a structure which is of 3 columns, but now we will make a structure of 4 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is something, a new part, which is not earlier. We have only this part in the previous cases, network address, next hop and interface. Why it is required here? Because we are given to the network. It is 8/16/24, but here we don't have information, so we are writing the slash n. How it works? When the packet goes to the router will take the destination address and then it will apply the slash n value. Now the slash n value will be from 0 to 32. So it will check for all the mask slash 32, slash 31, slash 20, 30, 29, 28. With every possible slash n value, it will check that this destination address is in the table or not. Now, what does that mean? I'll show you one example. So, one thing to remember is we have now 4 columns. Now, I'll give an example to make it simpler. Now, this is the example. We want to make a routing table for R1. Earlier, we are making for means when we talk of the making routing tables, we make 3 tables, class A table, class B, class C table. But now we will not make 3 different tables, but we make only 1 table and a single table will be there. So what we do, we will make a table like this. We have 4 columns are there. Column 1. Now column 1 is for the slash n value. So here you can see if you are making for R1, R1 connects to 22, 25, 24 and 26. So I will make, let's say 26. And then what is the network address? Network address is 180.70.65.192. And what is the next hop address? What is the address? Blank, because this is connected directly, right? And what is the interface? M2, very good. So this entry is finished. Now I will look for, let's say, 25. If you have 225, you can write 25 25. If you have two networks with /25, you write three entries. So I am looking for 25. So what is the address? 180.70.65.128, and this is also directly and M0. Similarly, I'll go for 24. This is 201.4.22.0, and this is also connected directly and through M3. Then we have last one, 22, which is 201.4.16. And what is the next hop here? Next hop is 180.70.65.200. So this is your routing table for R1. Now we'll take an example and see what is happening. Now you have to decide if this is the packet goes to the router, and we are assuming the classless addressing, then what the router will do. So the first step is, you need to, now there is no need to apply all from 32/32/31/30. It's not required to do all the possible combination. The router will just look at the table, and the first entry is /26. Is it okay? So what the router will do, it will find the /26. The /26 means what is the mask. So if you go with /26, so mask is what? Mask is 255.192. Now you have to find a network address, so you will just do the end operation, 180.70.65.140. so when you do, what you get? You get 180.70.65, and 192 you can write as 128 plus 64, and 140 you can write as 128 plus 12. So the answer is 128. Is it okay? Now we are doing this /26, so we will look this value, this address, in this row /26, and we will find that this is not matching. So the router will check for the next entry, which is /25. So now if I want to do /25, then /25 is what? This is 255. Is it okay? And when you do this end operation, what do you get? You get 180.70.65.128. Now you search this value in /25 row, and in /25 row you will find a match. This is found. So what is the answer? Actually, this means this address is directly connected to a network with this router, and you will forward through interface M0. This is the decision. Okay, this part. Now, so far we have seen that this is given to us. We are provided with this topology. This is a topology. How the things are connected. And with the topology, we have designed the routing table. But now we will do in the reverse operation. We are given with this routing table, and we will design this topology. So vice versa, right? So this is given to us. So the question says, if this information is given to us, is it possible to design a topology? So we will see. Actually, we can, this is possible to design, but we cannot make a comment for all the connections. We have not full information. We have actually partial information. So whatever the information we have provided here, we will try to make a topology. So here you can see, this is blank part. That means these networks are thread connected, right? So what you do, you can make something like this. This is maybe your router, and here this connects with M0, and there is a network which this is 110.70.0.0/16. This part we have covered, right? Then M2, so we have something called M2 also. So this is M2 interface, and here we have a network which is T.14.0.0/16. This is also done. Then we have M1. Let's say there is another interface M1 which connects to the network 190.17.0.0/16. This part is okay. So we have finished with this, this, and this. Now let us take this one, M1. So we have another network, this one, which connects through M1, but we have no proper information that how this connection is made. So what we can do through M1, M1 is this one. So we can say through M1, there is something connected, some network is connected, whose address is 3.4.8.0/24. So we can say that there exists one network. This network is somewhere exists, and in order to forward a packet to this network, we will forward the packet through M1. Okay, but we are not sure that how this is connected. Okay, so but we know that it is connected through the interface here. This the IP of this is 190.17.6.2. But we have no information about this, that what is the connection, how many routers are involved here. We have no information. Okay, similarly, if you go to this M2 is this. So we have information that there is some network exists 140.6.2. So let's say this is one network here whose network address is 140.6.12.64. Now to go to this network, we have the information that we have to forward. Okay, and similarly we have default information. So M0 means it goes from here and it connects to, we don't know it how it is connected here. This is your default. So it goes through M0, and here we have this IP of this is this thing. Okay, because there is no space to write, so I have just make an arrow. So you understood how the things work. This is the core idea. So this is what we have designed. So we have information that this is connected directly, and but this have we have no information that how this is connected. But we have idea that it has to go through M1. We have no information about this structure.